Good morning, students. Today, let's study the uses of acid. Sulfuric acid, the formula of sulfuric acid is H2SO4. Now, the sulfuric acid is used in the preparation of fertilizer such as superphosphate. Now, what is this superphosphate? It is a fertilizer. Batteries of cars, trucks and inverters. So acids are used in the batteries. So over here the chemical energy is converted into electrical energy. So acids helps it is used over here to generate the energy. To put it in simple words, it is used in the generation of energy. It is used in making drugs, paints, dyes, detergents, plastics, etc. It is also used in textile industry, it means cloth making industry, paper and leather industry. What is the purpose of using? It is used for dyeing purpose or coloring purpose. You have acidic dyes which are used as used for the dyeing purpose. It also helps to remove salt deposits or scales from steam boilers. Now, chemical reactions are carried out in a large steam boilers. Now, during that reaction, salts are being generated. So, there are salt deposition that is seen in the steam boilers. These are huge, big drum-like structures. So, a process called as descaling is done. That means the salt is being removed with the help of an acid. So, that process is descaling. Here, we see that with the help of an acid, descaling or salt is removed. Purification of common salt. We use the presence of an acid. Acid is required. And even purification of noble metals. Noble metal means the metals that are not at all, they are not reactive. For purification of gold, silver, again acid is being used. Vinegar, it is prepared from acetic acid solution in water. So acetic acid is an acid, the name itself is telling you. So this is, vinegar is nothing but acetic acid solution in water. So, this is used as a preservative. For example, pickles. Acetic acid is used in the preparation of baking powder. So, these are the uses of acids and very important. Next, we will study bases. It gives negative hydroxide or hydroxyl ion in water. In acid, we studied that it gives rise to H+. Here in base, we see it gives rise to hydroxide or OH-. Remember students, acid, it gives rise to H+. Base, it gives rise to OH- in water. Strong bases. Now, what are strong bases that dissociate completely in water? Dissociate means it separates completely, totally in water. For example, NaOH. So, when you add NaOH in water, it breaks up into Na+ and OH-. Again, when you dissolve potassium hydroxide, KOH is potassium hydroxide. When you dissolve it, it breaks up to give rise to K+, OH-. In both cases, we see OH- ion is being released. So, strong bases, they dissociate completely or break down completely in water. And they are corrosive and can burn the skin. Corrosive means they can damage the skin. Weak bases, they do not dissociate completely. Means they do not break down completely. Example, zinc hydroxide, copper hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide. So, these are weak bases and they are not corrosive or they do not cause damage unlike the strong bases. physical properties of bases. They are bitter. Example, all the antacids that are used to reduce the acidity. Okay, they are all bases and they are usually bitter in nature. And red litmus is turned to blue. Litmus is obtained from the lichen and this is an indicator. So how do we know a particular solution is basic in nature? When it can convert blue litmus to red litmus to blue. Phenolphthalein again is an indicator. If it changes to pink, then it is a base. Methyl orange again is an indicator. If it changes to yellow, then it is a base. It is slippery to touch. It is a good conductor of electricity in solutions. It is corrosive in nature. It means it can cause damage. Only the strong bases are corrosive in nature and also cause blisters. I have already told you blisters are nothing but it is filled with pus, the wound that is filled with pus. Now, what are alkalis? Very important question. What are these alkalis? Water soluble bases. There are certain bases that are soluble in water. Such bases are known as alkalis. Example is sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide. So these are the bases that are soluble in water and they are known as alkalis. All alkalis are bases, but all bases are not alkalis. Students, this statement is important. All alkalis are nothing but bases that are soluble in water. All those alkalis are bases, but it is not a definite or hard and fast rule that all bases should be an alkali. Not needed. All the bases are not alkali. Not all bases are soluble in water. There are certain bases that are soluble in water and they are known as alkalis. And I've already given you example of sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide. Let's look at the uses of bases. It is used in the whitewash solutions. It reduces the acidity of soil. So when the soil is too very acidic, to bring down the acidity, we add the base. Calcium hydroxide, it is used in the bleaching powder. It helps in the brightening of white cloths. It is also used in laboratory reagent or it is used in labs. It is used in the manufacture of soap, medicines, fibers, plaster, motor, etc. Motor is a device that is used to pound something. Okay, so it is used in the manufacture of all these things. Washing soda preparation, so base is used in the preparation of washing soda or softening hard water. Now, what do I mean by softening hard water? Now, water contains certain salts like calcium and magnesium. Now, this calcium and magnesium has to be removed because that is a reason for the hardness of water so calcium and magnesium salts have to be removed from the water. So that is brought about by the addition of base. That is known as softening of hard water. It means removing of calcium and magnesium salts. It is used in the paper making. It is used in the manufacture of fertilizers and synthetic fibers. It is used as a cleaning agent, ink remover. And it is also used as an antacid. Okay, when there's too much acidity in the stomach, that time antacid or a base is taken. Testing acids and bases. Now, how do we say that a particular solution or particular substance is an acid or a base? either by tasting. We know acid is sour, whereas base is bitter. Or by touching. Acids burn on touching, bases are soapy. So strong acids cause skin burns like nitric acid and sulfuric acid. Sodium hydroxide and potassium hydroxide, it is also used in the manufacture of soap and washing soda. So these two points are important over here. Touching, acids burn on touching, remember that, whereas bases are soapy in nature. So by touching you can find out the difference. Indicator, a chemical substance that is used to identify whether a particular compound is acidic or basic by showing a color change. So indicators are what? They are nothing but a chemical substance. Now there are few natural indicators like red cabbage, China rose, lichens, and synthetic indicators like phenolphthalein and methyl orange. When I say synthetic, it is man-made. Litmus solution or paper. So litmus is available in form of a solution as well as paper. So purple dye obtained from lichens. So litmus is purple in color and it is obtained from lichens. When you add this dye, purple dye, when you add it to the distilled water, distilled water does not have any minerals in it. It will form what is known as, or we will get what is known as litmus solution. Dye, purple dye, when we dissolve it in water, we get litmus solution. Now, in presence of an acid, it will turn red. In presence of base, it will turn blue. This is in case of paper, litmus paper. You also get solution, red litmus solution. You also get blue litmus solution, red litmus solution. If solution is an acid, then it will turn to red. If it is a base, then it will turn to blue. So by means of this color change, we can get to know whether a particular substance is an acid or a base.